Hi there. Welcome to your quick bite of cloud engineering. I'm Laura, and today we're here to chat about concurrency. So what exactly is concurrency? Well, concurrency is the idea that a system can handle multiple things happening in a set period of time with no set order in which those things start or finish. Among all of the common examples to explain concurrency is a simple banking account accessed by a handful of people. Each person can make one transaction at a time, and the order of the transactions is as random as a human's interaction with a system. Person A could be making a deposit at the same time as person C is making a withdrawal, and person B could decide to make a deposit while person C's withdrawal is processing. The actions of each person are processed by the system as they come in, sometimes in parallel, with the end result being the sum of those transactions. Another common example is a single person serving multiple tables at a restaurant. Each table has a different length of time it takes for the diners to finish eating, and the person serving the tables processes each transaction based on a random order. In the end, hopefully, the diners all order, are served, eat, pay, and leave. That's lovely and all, but what does this have to do with cloud computing? Well, if you're running your applications and workloads on the cloud, you're likely running your applications across many different pieces of hardware, on many different virtual systems, and likely even across data centers. Inputs from users are random and will trigger different parts of your applications or workloads at various points. Your application is serving hundreds of thousands of users at any one point in time, who are making requests and processing transactions, just like a restaurant or a banking account. In short, your application and infrastructure are parts of a concurrent distributed system. Tracking state, which we explored in another video, is one way to get a snapshot of all of the things happening in a system at once. So the state of a system is extremely important for concurrent distributed systems. State enables us to watch for deadlocks, or moments when there is no way for a system to reach a desired state because two or more actions are blocking one another from needed resources. Cloud computing, and as an extension of cloud computing, cloud engineering, hinges on being able to handle distributed computing and concurrency gracefully. Applications need to get the same results every time, regardless of the state changes between the initial state and the end state. Just imagine a data store that fell over every time a process attempted to connect to it while another connection was active. Cloud-native systems running on containers or applications running as serverless functions need to execute cleanly, even if they're running at the same time in different places and are dependent on one another in some fashion. So, understanding concurrency and the related concept of state is critical to understanding cloud-native systems. This has been your quick bite of cloud engineering for this week. If you like this video, please share it. Sharing it and, of course, liking it and subscribing to our channel helps out our channel and helps me make more videos like this for you. Also, if you want to learn about something specific, leave me a note down in the comments. I do read those. Or open an issue in our GitHub repo that I'm linking in the description below. I'll be back in just 2 weeks for another quick bite. Take care. Bye. Hey, cloud engineers, Laura here. I'm just here to remind you that if you have a topic you would love to have us cover here on Pulumi TV, all you have to do is go to github.com/Pulumi/Pulumi TV. You can add an issue there and let us know what topic you'd like us to talk about. Thanks so much. Bye.